your HT is basically playing with words.
Right.
Words in the sense using the right words. Candidates kya karte, usually they use generic words like, you know, intelligent, hardworking, honest, trustful, etc. etc. Yeah, I made a set of words which are, you know, not very common and which is accurate. For example, idealistic, optimistic, or, you know, extroverted, introverted, resourceful. Even if, see, what happens in GD is your choice of words. What I made mistake was, I used words like, you know, but I don't think gentlemen, but I feel. So involuntarily, I was breaking the group. So that is what happened in my first attempt. First is never interrupt someone when there is an idea which is working.
Hello friends, welcome back to Defense Roger and I hope you're doing good. My name is Sheetal Yadav and aajke jo hamare guest hain, unka naam Sagar hai. Unhe SSB Kolkata se recommendation mila unke dusre attempt mein and he was the only one who got recommendation from that batch for a Navy entry. The special thing about Sagar is that he is having a political background, apart from which he is willing to serve the armed forces. So let's welcome Sagar to our platform, Defense Roger. Sagar, welcome to Defense Roger. Firstly, congratulations on your recommendation. You got a recommendation from SSB Kolkata. And आपके बारे में मुझे बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो fascinate कर रही हैं. Firstly, आप SSB Kolkata से solo recommend हुए हो. It's very rarest to the rare. And secondly, you are a BTech graduate. You're a national level football player. And you have a lot of opportunities. Apart from that, you are having a political background. But you still chose to go for armed forces. That really inspired me. We are going to talk about all those things in this interview. But can you go, before any further delay, can you give a quick introduction about yourself?
Yes. Thanks for having me, Sheetal, first of all. Yeah, regarding my introduction, I'm Sagar B M. I did my schooling 11th, 12th and engineering in Mysore. I'm from Mysore. Okay. I did my 11th, first standard to 12th in state syllabus, and I completed engineering from VTU, which is one of the reputed colleges in Karnataka. Okay. And so that's a quick introduction about myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
and I also play football and everything.
Yeah. You are a national level football player. You just don't play football, but you're a national level player. And Sagar, agar baat kare aapke baare mein, so apart from so many things you could have opted in your life, but you chose armed forces. So what really inspired you to go for Indian Navy particularly? So what was the reason?
There was nothing particular as Indian Navy, Indian Army or Indian Air Force. I always wanted to join the dry forces, you know. And I was an NCC cadet. I joined NCC in my engineering, that too in my third year, it was extremely, extremely late, because of which I could only complete my B certificate and I could not complete my C certificate. And yeah, what inspired me basically was, in Mysore, there's a air show which goes about, and it is during the Dashara, the Mysore Dashara, which is quite famous in Mysore. And in my third grade, when I was a kid, third grade or fourth grade, my dad used to usually take me there, and I was always fascinated looking at the Sarang team perform and the para commandos jump out of the helicopter and everything. That is where it started for me. From there, it slowly started building. I slowly started liking the you know, war movies and everything, like the border, etc.
Right. Luxury and border are two prominent movies which is hit off all the defense aspirants. So Sagar, aapko recommendation mila second attempt mein. And first attempt, unfortunately, you got conference out. So during the gap of these two SSB, what kind of preparation you did at that time? And considering both mentally and physically. So if somebody is watching this interview, what kind of suggestion you want to give if they are going for the very first SSB?
Okay. If you're going for the very first attempt, first get to know what is there, what is required by SSB, and what sorts of activities are taking place in SSB. Basically, the first introduction which you get to know about SSB, and zyadatar you'll get to know about SSB when you get inside the SSB, not while studying. That is where I also felt I missed it out on my first attempt. When I went there and when I read about it, I used this book called Natarajan, which is quite a famous book, like Natarajan sir. Yeah. So I read a lot of things, why GTO, why what is the importance of psych and everything. So when I read about it, I had a fair image, but not a clear image. So when I went there and I appeared my first SSB, that is where I got a clear picture ki what, so what has to be done and what they require from a candidate. And that was a very short instance. I was not able to prepare myself in that 5 days. And when I came back home after getting conference out, I prepared myself ki what is the actual requirement which is required. I started focusing on being factual. I started focusing on being, knowledge centric and not something like SIE. Like, you see, if you read something about something, you know completely about it, not ki upar upar se padh liya. For example, if you're reading a newspaper, it's not like only you read the headlines of the newspaper, you have to read the whole story. That is where I was, missing it out, and where that is how I prepared my second attempt. And in terms of physical, I am a football player, as you know, and my schedule was such ki I didn't have any obstacles or something like that which hindered me in not doing physical activities. I was very active and physical, so that I didn't have any problem with that. If someone is going for their first attempt, I recommend them to run every day for at least 5 kilometers. And also build on their physical strength, and also their muscle strength and everything. That helps you a lot in SSB. Yeah.
Before going to the screening process, Sagar, what kind of SSB is SSB Kolkata? Because it is quite new and people are much not aware about the SSB center. So how was your experience at SSB Kolkata?
So unlike any other board, SSB Kolkata, you have to report one day earlier. For example, usually in other posts, it is 6 a.m. in the morning and you report the same day as what happens. But in Kolkata, it's quite different. It's not exactly in Kolkata. You have to report in Kolkata and they'll take you by bus to that place. That's called Diamond Harbour. There's about 3 to 4 hours from Kolkata. And you have to report on the previous day at 9 a.m. And 12 a.m. it is completely documentation and everything. And from 12 to, it takes about 3 hours. We'll reach there at 3 and again, we'll have our lunch there. And after that, a small documentation and briefing session. And again, the next day, we stay there. And the next day, our CA starts, and that's how it starts. That's how it goes about in Kolkata.
Okay. Yeah. So Sagar, talking about screening process, screening test consists of a lot of 4 tests, but talking primarily about OIR. OIR ko leke bahut sare misconceptions hote hain ki agar OIR ka importance nahi hai, well, if you don't perform well, also you will get selected if you focus on PPDT, because PPDT ek zyada weightage rakhta hai. To is tarah ke bahut sare misconceptions hote hain. What is your take on that thing?
OIR and PPDT, it is a holistic approach. SSB is meant to be like that. So there is no specific weightage for PPDT or OIR. It is a combined distinct process where both are evaluated. If it was only PPDT, then they would have done only PPDT. Why they would have done OIR after stage 2? There is a certain weightage for OIR as well. And if someone is attempting SSB for the first time, I would recommend them to get some good sleep before the senior day, and practice OIR before giving SSB. And and for PPDT, I feel my approach was I used to take pictures. Some of my friends recommended that I have to take pictures wherever I am and write a story on it. So I had quite a good number of friends who had the same goal and same orientation. So we used to take pictures and share in the group, and we used to narrate stories on it. I used to discuss it as well. So that is how my PPDT went about. And one major thing is 4 minutes. You have to describe the story. That requires a lot of practice. You could tell why, what led to the situation, what is the current status of this thing, and what is the future of that situation. So for that you require practice, and I would suggest people to practice quite good number of pictures before preparing for SSB. And also focus on the knowledge and also the common sense. It is a combined this thing. So यार ये नहीं कि उसने ये स्टोरी लिख दिया तो मैं भी वही स्टोरी लिखूंगा. इट इज एवरीबडी हैज अ डिफरेंट माइंडसेट, यू नो, एवरीबडी थिंक्स इट इन अ डिफरेंट वे. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर समवन इज स्विमिंग, फॉर एग्जांपल अगर कोई बंदा है जो इट यू नो पानी में है और पिक्चर ऐसा डिपिक्ट किया, तो फ्यू माइट सी इट एज ड्राउनिंग एंड फ्यू माइट सी इट एज स्विमिंग. इट्स बेसिकली ऑन यू. So even if it's he is drowning, you can save him and you can make it positive by, you know, being the lifeguard or whatever. And even if it's swimming, you can use Olympics or you can use any other triathlon event or something like that. So it's basically on your approach and how you take about it, and depends on what comes to your mind on in that 30 seconds.
Cool.
And while narrating, I feel yeah, one thing, don't stumble. Don't use, as you know, those kind of words should be avoided. And while in GD as well, don't interrupt anyone. Obviously, in PPT ke GD mein, usually it's a fish market. But try to, if someone is talking, try to look at them and nod your head. If you feel it is right, try to nod it. Even if it's not, at least have eye contact with the person. Don't ever look at the assessors. Never do that. And whoever is talking, and even when the first person is narrating, and if you are the last person sitting at the 12th chair or 15th chair or 20th chair, please look at the person who is narrating and please nod your head.
Mm-hmm.
And your body language matters a lot. Although this is not mentioned anywhere, your body language is something which is seen and which is observed in SSB. That is how even I got screened in. So keep your body posture straight. Keep your body posture, which is, you know, which seems like you're welcoming the opposite candidate or someone.
Right.
That is how you go about your PPDT and everything.
I believe, Sagar, they have a absolute idea of how to write the PPDT story as well as what is the importance of IR. Now, moving to the stage two, that plays a very important role because now you get to stay for 4 days, and starting with the psychological test, that consists of TAT, VET, SRT, ST. So what is your approach regarding these 4 tests and how you performed and what kind of challenges you faced according to your previous SSP and how you improved it?
Okay. So TAT is one area where I practiced a lot. So in my first attempt also, it went well. And in my second attempt also, it went well. So how I went about it was, I, as I mentioned in my PPT as well. So it was basically taking pictures of wherever you are, or even if I was going for a walk, I was taking a picture there. If I was going for a movie, picture there, and again narrate it with my friends. If I was going for some session or class, again picture and narrate it. So what major thing I was focusing was 4 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
To describing the situation in 4 minutes. So when I started evaluating myself, I felt if I connect my personal stories or personal scenarios which happened to me, it is much easier for me to, you know, write it down in 4 minutes rather than taking another imaginative approach. If you have personal experience, that is much easier for me to, you know, write it down and, you know, compress it in 4 minutes. So that was my approach for this thing. And coming down to the last picture in that, the 12th picture. Twelfth picture is something which you can, you know, you have a lot of time. You can think about it and you can relate it to your life, basically. Mm-hmm. You can write a story which is related to you and which is reflected, which reflects you on the GTO grounds and also in the interview. And also in the conference round. Mm-hmm. That can help a lot. Rather than writing some story which is given in the book or which is given on the
internet. That is the best story somebody can take advantage through that tool.
Yeah. Please write something which is related to you and not a story which is given in the book or on the internet.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Talking about VAT ke the 15 seconds hi hote hain, and then we have to write the like sentences. So how you utilize those 15 minutes, those 15 seconds to write the whole sentences?
So when I did my VAT for the first time, I was like 15 minutes, 15 seconds the bahut hote yaar. 15 seconds, I can write a poem in 15 seconds. But when I went there and I sat for the first, in my first interview, I think 15 seconds, oh my God, it was extremely quick.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Then somehow slowly I picked up. And what trick I was using is, for example, if there is a negative word in the a set of words, I used to write it down in one corner of the page, and I used to leave it blank. And when you get time for, you know, checking your paper or something, some that time I used to fill it up. Or when you get time to, you know, go back and discuss a word, go back and, you know, stay out and come back for the PPDT, you still have your papers with you, so you can write it at that point of time before submitting. That is how I was going with VAT, and it's not though I didn't feel it was that difficult. It was easy. I practiced a lot of words. Even in the gap term, I practiced a lot of words, especially negative words and tricky words like mother, father, brother, son. These are words which are kind of tricky.
Those words, those are difficult.
Yeah.
Instead of easy words.
Yeah, I practice those words. Usually one or two words like those come into your VAT. So,
right.
Yeah.
Moving to the SRT, we get a situation and we have a set of situations, like 60 situations are given. So what is your take on that? Aapki approach kya thi SRT karte hue?
Yeah, SRT is something which depicts your real life actions. Okay, so you have to use your common sense basically. First thing is try to, you know, put your real life scenario in the question, like, you know, juxtapose it on your real life scenario. First thing is, for example, if a kid is falling on the ground and you're going to the school and you find him bleeding and everything, what would be your approach to it? First of all, yaar, agar school ja rahe ho, you obviously won't have first aid kit in your bag.
Right.
Napkin, have water bottle. Handkerchief, yeah. Have a napkin or handkerchief. It's just, you know, wipe his blood first with your napkin or tie the blood with your listing and give him water.
Right.
Because we're a kid, we're not trained to, you know, treat him in terms of medical or anything like that. You can call the ambulance or you can help. You can call for nearby help, or if there is any, store or nearby, you can call him. You can use his phone and call the ambulance or something, and you can go back to your school. There's nothing. I've heard scenarios where I've heard people describing it, and they're taking the same kid to the hospital and everything. It is not required. Yeah, obviously in the ambulance there are people. There are doctors present in the ambulance. There is no need of you going to the hospital and helping them.
Right.
It's really that is SRTs. Yeah, you have to basically use your common sense.
Adding one more thing, Sagar, you know, sometimes what the candidates do, they focus on primary scenarios instead of focusing secondary. I mean, if you have seen, like, agar aap raaste mein
they miss out on
primary ko bhul jaate hain, and space secondary kisi ke accident ho, isko hospital to pahuncha diye, and then they forget to go back to school. So they have seen also. So presence of mind bhi dekha jata hai SRTs mein. And agar main Sagar baat karu SD is something we can prepare beforehand, right? Because we know the things to be written. So,
how did you SD? SD is basically playing with words.
Right.
Words in the sense, using the right words. Candidates, kya karte? Usually they use generic words like, you know, intelligent, hardworking, honest, trustful, etc. etc. I made a set of words which are, you know, not very common and which is accurate. For example, idealistic, optimistic, or, you know, extroverted, introverted, resourceful, and etc. So what I did was, jo hai yaar, I actually asked my parents and friends and also my football coach, what does he think about myself and about me actually, and I wrote it down, and whichever seemed very much, you know, apparent, I wrote it down and I noted it, and that is what I wrote in my STS. For example, my parents think I'm very affectionate, or I'm, you know, very generous towards kids. I buy a lot of even my neighbors and all, there are a lot of kids around me, so I keep buying them chocolates, biscuits and everything. My mom usually doesn't like it, so that is what I wrote in my STT as well.
Okay.
And even my football coach actually mentioned that I'm not very, you know, out of the course kind of a guy. I'm always oriented towards the goal.
Okay.
So, you know, motivating the team towards the goal. So that is again what I wrote. And usually, even my again, one more example was I asked my dad as well, what do you think about me? So he said, he actually said this word, but he doesn't know English, but he said it in Kannada. And same thing, I translated and I wrote it as resourceful. Usually me and my father have this, you know, resourceful conversations in the evenings and everything. We talk about politics, we talk about elections, we talk about everything. So he actually said that and I wrote it as well. And this was asked in my interview as well.
Okay.
What do your parents think about you? What are the few plus points about your father? What are your negatives about your mother, etc., etc.? So I was very, you know, this was somewhere I had to, you know, relate my SGT and my listening interviews. So yeah, whatever I was in my SGT was the same thing which I said in my interview as well. Nothing special or nothing.
So Sagar, moving ahead, let's talk about interview. Interview is one of the crucial decision-making activity that is done in SSB, because you get to interact one-on-one with the assessors. And that whole time, the assessor is interested in knowing you, your journey, your relationships with your surrounding people and what you have done till now. They ask you different CIQ situations with it and they try to test your knowledge. So I got a lot of things to be discussed. So since it was your Navy entry, so us related to aapse questions puche, ultimately kis tarah ka environment tha, I am interested in knowing that.
Okay. So let's talk about in my interview. In my first interview, what I realized was not being factual. So basically, if he was asking any question, I was giving some random answer. I was just being confident and giving some random answer. But when he was countering the question, I was not able to answer that. So that is where I felt I was going wrong. And for my second interview, I was prepared for that. And aisa nahi ki direct no bol dunga answer ke liye, question ke liye. So I was just learn about it, sir. I'll get back to you at the conference around. I'll research about it. Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it, but I'll get back to you in the conference. The words were like that. And that is one place where I improved on myself in my first attempt.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing which is which really matters is your PIQ.
Right.
And one major mistake which people do is write extra.
This is for your cues. Right.
For example, agar kuch unhone nahi kiya and they added your PIQ, you're giving an extra avenue for the interviewer to ask questions and you're really not aware about it. So that is where actually interviewers somehow they find out that you are not into that and they catch you there.
Right.
So please write whatever is in your this thing and whatever you have done till now. Mm-hmm. And if you've not done, aray, koi nahi, just leave it black. My half of my PIQ was empty.
Okay.
So yeah, don't make huge mistakes. And when you're writing about one thing which majorly matters was knowing about your hometown.
Mm-hmm.
You have to know a lot about your hometown. If you ask something about your hometown, you have to be in a situation where you can tell which he does, or he or she wouldn't know. For example, I'm from Mysore.
Right.
And he told me, and the question which was asked was, tell me something which I'm not aware about Mysore. So I had to answer that.
Okay, what was your answer?
So usually what answers people give was Mysore Palace and etc. What I gave was the first Asia, the first school dedicated to women was started in Mysore, in the whole of Asia. First zoo in the whole of Asia was in Mysore. First electricity pole which gave street light was again in Mysore, etc. This is out of the box kind of an answer. I made at least notes about Mysore for four pages. Like four pages maine sirf Mysore ke bare mein likha tha maine. That is one thing how I went about. Sir, what you have to do is PIQ mein phobi lekar aaye, you have to know everything about it.
Right.
If you're writing something about your extracurricular activities, for example, I had written cycle repairing, which is not very common. Okay. And that is how I wanted him to ask the question in, related to that, and that is what happened. He asked me why do you have cycle repairing when everybody has other hobbies or everything.
Right.
So I said, sir, I actually worked in Decathlon for quite a few time, and that is where I, you know, started liking cycle repairing and everything. Mm-hmm. For example, agar koi hai jo mere mohalle, matlab in my community, somebody is, you know, some kid is finding difficulty in repairing his cycle, I'll help him, or I'll fix his cycle, or I'll fix my own cycle whenever required, everything. So that is where my hobby for cycle repairing started.
This is a very unique hobby, actually. People just try to show sketching or hiking, and people try to put in whatever thing possible, you know, and that's... But this is something unique that you have put. I've heard for the very first time from somebody like...
Yeah, he counted also. He's like, tell me 10 parts which is necessary in a cycle.
Okay.
What are the extra fitting which is required in a cycle? What is the basic cost? What are the three types of cycles? Basically, those kind of questions. Three types of cycles are basically mountain bike, road bike, and hybrid cycles. Things like that.
All right.
Yeah. So that is one thing about BIQ. And let's related to the Navy questions. Navy questions may... Yeah, I think you have to know the basics about whatever entry you're going through. You have to know the basics. If you're going for a pilot, you have to know what aircraft which the Navy operates. Or if you're going for GSX, what are the kind of ships which the Navy operates. For me, it was naval. Basically, naval constructor ka kaam kya hota hai. That I had to know. And some basics about abhi jo projects chal raha hai Navy ka. Project 75i. 17A, 17 Bravo, 15 Alpha, 15 Bravo, everything. I had to know basics at least about it. And I studied that.
Mm-hmm.
But in the interview, they didn't ask, but in the conference, they asked me a few questions about Navy.
Okay.
Interview mein sirf basic pucha tha, ki name any few ports which is operated by Indian Navy, etc., etc. And Indian Army will be same hua tha. In my first unit it was the Indian Army. It was in Allahabad. So there they asked me what arms would you opt for when you pass out from your academy. So I told it's an engineering corps because I'm from engineering background. So he asked me what is the basic job of an officer in engineering corps? What does engineering corps do? So I had to answer that. Yeah. And yeah. One mistake what I found in my first unit was telling extra. Agar maine pucha hai ki, what does an engineering officer do? To maine, I had to just tell ki, as a naval, as a civil engineer, I had to tell ki, laying of mines, making roads, etc., etc. To maine extra mein bol diya, MES, BRO, ye sab maine, I had to just tell him ki, I know about it. Unnecessary. Yeah, ho gaya. So it created an avenue for him to ask questions. So that is where I got stuck again in my interview, my first attempt. So that is what I made sure that doesn't happen in my second attempt. It didn't happen in my second attempt.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I got a lump sum idea what kind of interview you had. I got to know a lot very different things from your interview, starting from your hobby to what kind of questions to be prepared for if you're going for certain particular entries. Now let's move to GTO. GTO is one of my favorite, and as you discussed, that it was a game changer for you. So GTO ke andar start karte hain, in do tasks se GD and GP kaisa kya, because now it is the first activity to be done in GTO. So how was it?
Okay, so let's talk about mera GD. To matlab it was I was lucky to get a topic which I was relevant about. Matlab I knew a lot about it. Even though I knew, I didn't initiate, because when you initiate, you get stuck, or you repeat the sentences, or you go out of course. So that is one thing which I wanted to avoid, and which happened in my first attempt as well. I initiated and I messed it up. So that is why I didn't want to initiate. I wanted to let others talk and, you know, get some more ideas about the topic, and, you know, support, or, you know, even if, see, what happens in GD is your choice of words.
Mm-hmm.
What I made mistake was I used words like but I don't think gentlemen, but I feel. So involuntarily I was breaking the group.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what happened in my first attempt. This was one major aspect where I felt that is the major reason why I got confidence as well.
Mm-hmm.
So again I worked on it, and I started using words like, you know, I agree to your point. Although if I was not agreeing, I was like, okay, correct, gentlemen, right. Yeah. So that is how I went about with my GD. And as far as the topic is concerned, usually when people talk about it, they usually go off course. That is one major thing which happens in the GD. Going off course is is leading, you're taking the group to a wrong discussion. That is where you go about. I usually focused on if something like that happened, I was trying to get back the group to the, you know, main area of focus. And I was, you know, trying to bond the group, like to
learn. It is a necessary thing. Yeah. If you're leading, we have to bring the whole group together.
Right. Yeah, whole group together. Even this, if it was a point against the group, I was like accepting it, and I was like, yeah, I agree to it. And that is how I focused on my GED. And coming down to GP is one aspect where you have to focus on the situations. Like, you have to give priorities for life, then materialistic things, then etc., etc. So first, make your priorities right. When there are situations, what I went about is when they give that sheet, I write the priorities first. First is again given to life, and again then the next materialistic thing, etc. I used to write it down, and then I used to write the paragraph or anything like that. When I did that, when my first attempt, I missed out on that. I did not write that. I memorized it, and somehow I missed one or two points, I guess. One or two situations. And when you write down the priorities, I don't think you'll miss out on any of the situations. And you can go ahead with everything. When it comes to GD, when it comes to group discussion about the group planning exercise, I feel everybody will have their own set of ideas, and will have their own set of priorities. So it's not necessary that your idea is the best idea. You have to agree to whichever idea you feel is better than yours, or if yours is the better, you have to try to put your idea. And when you're trying to put your idea, you have not not degrade anyone, any other ideas or any other suggestions. Even if your idea is good, but there is a better idea, please agree to it. And, you know,
exactly.
Please address it. Please acknowledge. And whenever someone is talking, please look into their eyes or look into their faces and nod your head. That is a very good sign of you accepting their ideas and everything. That gives a very positive outlook about your body language.
Okay. Yeah. So moving to the ground task, what was the first few task that was conducted in ground?
Our first task was a snake race.
Okay.
Yeah, snake race is one thing which you have to enjoy in SSBR. Exactly. That is extremely a very good event where you can, you know, shout your heart out and you can motivate others. Mm-hmm. Yeah, wahi to hai. That is officer-like qualities. That is where you can show your officer-like qualities.
Exactly.
You have to shout your... I being a team player, I loved snake race. Every time I love snake race.
Okay. And
yeah.
What are the other sequence of activities?
The next was individual obstacles for us on CM day. Mm-hmm. And your individual obstacles for me was, you know, it was quite easy only. But one area where I faced problem was in the balancing thing, the zigzag balance. And it was wet on that day, and my sole was also not good, and I was slipping a lot. So I again, the major area for me which I face difficulty is that balancing thing. I don't know for what reason, but I face difficulty in that. I realized that in my first attempt, and to address that, I did the balancing thing in my first as my first thing obstacle in my second attempt. So my second attempt, my first obstacle was that balancing thing. I tried a lot. I tried like two or three times, but I failed. So I'm like, okay, it's a problem. I went about and made a map, actually, route map in my mind. Can go between 10, 9, 8 or something like 10, 7, 6, 5, 3. Again, come back to 9. I made a route map. Every SSB has their own, set of and arrangements also. So whichever is nearby and whichever is, you know, easier to complete first, or which is according to your stamina and your skill set, you can go ahead with that. You can make a route map in your own, on your own mind, on this thing, and you can go about with that. Okay, so talking about progressive group task and all the other tasks, that is one thing which, again, it is not about initiation. It is about giving your right ideas and giving, and, you know, using proper set of words while you're even giving your ideas or even when interrupting someone. First is never interrupt someone when there is an idea which is working. Never interrupt. If the idea is working, please ask them to, you know, go out with that idea and you agree on that, what basically. And how I played my game in my PGT was, usually the first task is always easy. It's just connecting the planks and crossing. So what I was doing is, I was just crossing that and I was looking at the second obstacle. I was always thinking, and I always wanted to find a solution for the second thing. It is usually tougher in the second, third and fourth obstacles. So I was always looking over that, and somehow I was not interrupting. I was standing little behind from the first set of candidates. So I was the last person. I was calmly looking into it, and they were trying a lot of ideas, but it was not working out. Suddenly I got an idea and I just raised my hand and I said, "Gentlemen, I have an idea."
Mm-hmm.
At first they were not listening, but then slowly they started,
answer.
They were not finding any solution. So I was the last one left out, and my idea somehow worked out.
Okay.
And I felt the GTO also was thinking, had the same solution in his mind. And somehow me and GTO connected there. And in every other scenario, wherever I had an idea, the GTO was like pointing at me and telling, listen to him. So, yeah, that was my thing with PGT, HGT and full group task. Basically, it's choice of words here. Never interrupt.
Definitely.
And be polite. Yeah, if your idea is working, please be cooperative. Do whatever is asking you to do. That is also an officer like quality, agreeing to, you know, seniors' command and everything. Yeah.
Command task that is quite related to these activities which are done in GTU. So how was your command?
So talking about my command task, first, before command task, it's a small interview with a small interaction with the GTO. So small interaction with the GTO, you know, it makes you a little more confident. You feel a little more accepted, and be confident. Tell whatever is there, tell whatever is true, and don't try to, you know, express something which is not there. You know, be factual. That's it. Be factual. And I felt more confident when I spoke to the GTO. He asked me, basically, why do you want to join the Navy and not any other forces? So there's this famous saying, I think even you have seen that reel on YouTube, this thing. Any other profession, any other company can give you a job, but the army will give you a life. So I said the same line, and I mentioned army in that line. And he's like, army? And I'm like, sir, sorry, the armed forces.
Yeah.
We have covered it up, and he was laughing. That is how it went about. And command task was quite challenging. I had moving objects in my command task. And he actually countered me. I found a solution in like 3 minutes or something. Not less than 3 minutes, probably. And I used rope and I found a solution. And he's like, there's no rope now. You have to use the bully and plank and find a solution. That I felt first finding solution was easier, but bully, I don't know, it was easier only. But I felt, I became a little nervous in that situation. And I took a lot of time, but somehow I found a solution and went about it.
Okay.
Yeah, and choosing the right, partners in your command task is also very important.
Exactly.
And sometimes they might even ask, why are you choosing those two cadets and why not others? Mm-hmm. So you have to have proper reinforcing statements as to why those two are part of this. Yeah.
So one of the last tasks, that is lecturate, where it knowledge is very much required. So how was the lecturate, by the way?
So lecturate, one of the misconceptions in lecturate is choosing the easiest topic.
Yeah, choose the toughest one and you'll succeed in.
So that is one of the, you know, majorly heard misconception, that you have to choose the toughest topic or the ideally easiest, not ideally the easiest topic. What happened in my interview was I used the easiest topic. My topic was online shopping.
Okay.
I was not, I mean, it's not like I didn't know about the other three topics, but I was not sure about the other three topics. I was not extremely confident about those three, and so instead of, you know, making a tumble there, I went for the easier one. And it was a quite a good lecture. It friends also liked it, even I liked it. And yeah, that was lecture. It it's better to go with the topic which you feel more confident in. For example, if there are topics which are tougher and you're confident about it, please go about with that one. In my first attempt, it was like that. I chose a difficult topic and I was confident about it. There was no issue in that. But in my second attempt, there was a topic which I was not aware about, or, you know, I was not confident about. So I chose an easier topic.
All right. Yeah. So, Sagar, we are done with psychological test, interview and the GTO. Now let's move to the conference. मेरे बहुत लोगों के कॉन्फ्रेंसेस हो रहे हैं सागर, बट आपका कॉन्फ्रेंस एक घंटे चला है, तो कॉन्फ्रेंस में पूछा गया आपसे।
सो मैं तो प्रिपेयर था कि मैं जाऊंगा, उन लोगों का सर फूड इन एसएसबी वाज गुड, द स्टे इन एसएसबी वाज गुड, दैट वाज गुड, ये बोल के आ जाऊंगा, बट एज सून एज आई वेंट आई सैड द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई गॉट फ्रॉम द प्रेसिडेंट वाज व्हाई वर यू नॉट रिकमेंडेड इन द फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट.
ओके.
तो like I was shocked, like pehla question to ye aa gaya. So then somehow I thought about it, and like, sir, I was going by the books. So he asked which book. He said, sir, under Natarajan sir ki book. Then Natarajan sir is not writing the right book, you're not getting recommended. Didn't get recommended in the first attempt. So what made you not get recommended in the first attempt? So I like, sir, again, sir, Natarajan sir is writing the right book, he's giving the right set of details which is required for a candidate, but it depends on your personality, so as to what kind of qualities you have to grasp from the book. So that is what I addressed, and he was slightly convinced. Then he asked any other reasons, any other avenues for which you're not recommended in the first attempt. So I said again, as I mentioned, the choice of words which I used in my GD, in my ETO tasks and everything. So I said that, sir, I was using my involuntarily, I was trying to break the group, and my choice of words are not right. But in this attempt, I've improved myself, and I've used words which, you know, kind of try to bond the group in one direction. So that was the first question which I faced in my conference. Then slowly he started asking, ki, what was the best or what are the events which you joined in SSB Kolkata? So I said snake race. Snake race is one thing which I always enjoy in my SSB interviews. So I said that, and he's like, okay, why did you like snake race? So I was like, sir, I'm a team player. I'm a sportsman. That is one thing which I will always love, is getting along, chilling with the team and going to the deadline or going to the goal and, you know, clearing it. That is one thing which I always love. Shouting out your slogan and motivating your fellow candidates is something which has always been me, and that is why I like snake race. So he asked me, what was your slogan, war cry? So I said, sir, it was Vande Mataram. I said Vande Bharat. I was into GK and everything. I studied a lot about Vande Bharat, because a lot of Vande Bharat trains were, you know, getting
okay.
Yeah, so I said Vande Bharat. He's like, what? I'm like, sorry, sir, Vande Mataram. So he also started laughing. Then I'm like, okay, what is the meaning? He asked me, what is the meaning of Vande Mataram? I'm like, sir, Hail India, Hail Mother India, since we, Vande is unite and Mataram is mother. So it's a Sanskrit word, etc. So that was the next question. And after that, he asked me, he gave SRTs in my conference round. Rather than interview, my SRTs were in the conference round. So he has situation where what was the most difficult task, if what was the most major issue or major complaint which you faced in the snake race, which you would like, if you were the captain or if you were the person who's commanding the team, what would have been your plan of execution? So I was like, sir, whatever happened was in this thing, we had the right plan, we had the right execution. Although if I had to improve on something, the placement of, there was one well-fed person in our group. So Yeah, I didn't mention fat or something. I just mentioned well-fed or healthy guy.
Okay.
So he started laughing for that. And I was like, oh, sir, if the position of him was not exactly appropriate, so I would either place him in the first position or in the last position. If it was in the first position, I will send him first, and he'll cheer us, and he'll motivate us to clear this thing. If he was in the last, we'll all clear it first, and we'll motivate him to clear the obstacles.
Okay.
So that was one first thing. And one more SRT he gave on that was, okay, Sagar, there is one person who's got screened in, but he's not interested in the armed forces. He has come basically on the pressure of his parents, and doesn't want to participate in the events. So what would be, if you are the captain, if you are the commanding this thing of your team, in the snake race, how would you approach him, or how would you make him do all the tasks and everything so that your snake race team comes first? Well, so first I said, sir, I'll address him. If you don't have so much time, what will you do? So I said, sir, if I don't have the time to address him, then only the placement of him matters a lot. So I'll be in the last, and I'll place him in the last second. I'll keep pushing him, keep kicking him, and I'll somehow clear the snake race, sir.
Okay.
Then he's like, yeah. Then after that, again, one more set of questions. He said, okay, one of your friend has bought a digital watch into SSB Kolkata. So, and you've seen him talking to someone using his digital watch, what would you do? My first reaction was, sir, I'll address him. First, obviously, that was my, even if it was that thing that occurred, I would have said the same thing. I would have addressed him, and I've asked him to report it to the concerned authorities. Then, sir said, ki, what if he doesn't listen to you? What would you do? Then I said, sir, obviously, I'll report to the concerned authorities. Then he said, he countered it saying, why not? He said, what if he, what, you're being a complaining person here. You're his friend, and you're complaining it to the concerned authorities. You're being a complaining person. Wow. Well, he won't trust you in any of the other tasks which is there in the SSB Kolkata list. So I was like, sir, if he has volunteered for the defense forces, then a certain set of rules which he has to follow. And if not, it is not a place for him, sir. That is why. So you will decide who is to get recommended or not. No, sir, but yeah. Then I was like, no, sir, but at least he has to follow a certain set of rules. It will also demotivate other set of candidates who have come for this thing. And it will also take them all off the course rather than being oriented in the process. I was
Exactly.
like, okay. Then again, he countered it saying, okay, no, you complained it, and they find an analog watch instead of a digital watch. Yeah, they check his baggage and everything. They find an analog watch instead of a digital watch. What would you do? Then I was like, sir, if I first in first scenario, if I have to complain, then I'll be 12% sure that it is a digital watch. I won't go by my instincts. It is not a situation where I have to go by my instincts. So I'll confirm it. I'll confirm it not once, not twice, but thrice. Only then I'll inform to the concerned authorities. If not, I won't complain, sir. So that was the question type of questions he asked in conference. And yeah.
And Sir can give you, see, recommendation is something we can always expect, but the only recommended is something, is nobody have ever thought. So what was your feeling at that time when it was when you were only one who got recommendation?
Yeah, the most funniest part was getting those pictures clicked. Yeah. I was the only one. I had no one to click my pictures. So I had to sit down and put the timer and stand. So that was one major issue which I faced if I getting recommended only was solo recommendation kind of thing. But other than that, I felt really good. I felt many of my other fellow candidates could have been recommended, but due to certain set of a wrongdoing, probably they would have missed it out, but I'm sure they'll also get recommended in the future attempts.
Wow, we are eagerly waiting you to join our forces whenever possible. The merit is out. And Sagar, we are very proud of you. And your journey has really taught me in terms of the whole SSP process, the certain barriers that people consider cases में ये नहीं करना चाहिए, वो नहीं करना चाहिए. But you literally put your thoughts out, and that is going to help literally a lot of candidates. And at last, Sagar, I want to know any suggestions you have for somebody who is about to go for the SSP through your journey, through your SSP experience.
Okay, yeah. Basically, stay focused, stay positive, and be up to date. Follow all the current affairs pages and follow. You be update yourself to the all the defense, procurement and everything.
Right.
Stay focused, stay positive. That is my advice to all the guys who are getting we're planning to give their SSB interviews.
Always, Sagar, it was lovely talking to you. We have come to an end, and I believe this interview is going to literally help a lot of candidates. Thank you so much for joining me for this interview. It was lovely talking to you.
Thanks a lot for having me, Cheetah.
Thanks for watching the video, and let me know in the comment section below if you have any doubts. Follow for more such content. Jai Hind.